स्टैंडर्ड 5 स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे इन दिस मोरल साइंस क्लास वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द रिफ्लेक्शन, पेज नंबर 33। सो लेट अस स्टार्ट लेसन 5, रिफ्लेक्शन। सो इन दिस इट इज गिवन रिफ्लेक्शन, ग्रीफ एंड सॉरो डू नॉट कम टू अस बाय चांस, दे आर सेंट टू अस बाय द डिवाइन मर्सी फॉर आवर ओन परफेक्टिंग। सो लेट अस डिस्कस अबाउट दिस कोटेशन, टेस्ट आर द बेनिफिट्स फ्रॉम गॉड फॉर विच वी शुड थैंक हिम। Grief and sorrow do not come to us by chance. They are sent to us by the divine mercy for our own perfecting. This is said by Abdul Baha. So let us see about that God gives us grief and sorrow. That is not come to us by chance. It is given by the God only. Why the God send us sufferings and sorrow? It is sent by the God by the divine mercy for our own perfection. That means the God wants to make us perfect. By the test, like in the school, if exams are held, they are held for the perfection of the student. Like that, God also sends us sufferings and sorrows to test our patience and to make us more perfect. So this is a saying. So let us see about this. A poem is also written by William Blake. Let us see. Joy and woe are woven fine, a clothing for the soul divine. That means joy and woe. If we are, God gives us happiness, God gives us sadness also. So when we accept the joy, the happiness given by the God, we should also accept the sadness, the grief or sorrow is also given by the God. They are woven fine. That means in the life we have both the side of the coin. One side we have sorrow also, one side we have happiness also. So both we should welcome. A clothing for the soul divine. For our soul, it is a clothing that they are both woven together in our life. Under every grief and pain runs a joy with silken twine. That means if God has given us sufferings and grief, then another time we can get happiness also. It is also woven with our sufferings. It is right it should be so. Man was made for joy and woe. God has made man for both. Now God takes our taste by giving us some suffering so that we can understand the life better and we can make ourselves perfect. And when this we rightly know, safely through the world we go. That means we should rightly understand God, what God wants. God makes us more perfect and God makes us more patient by giving us sorrow with joy. So we should welcome both. You can see here one more quote is there. Happiness and sadness. Sadness gives us depth. Happiness gives height. If sadness is giving us depth, we can make ourselves more patient. Deeply we can understand the life. Happiness also gives us height. Both are equal. Equally important in our life. Sadness gives roots, happiness gives branches. That means sadness is also important to make us more perfect. That means it makes us more stronger, like roots. Happiness gives branches. That means happiness is also important to spread the life, to understand the life more and more. Happiness is like a tree going into the sky and sadness is like the roots going down into the womb of the earth. That means both are important. If happiness is important to make us going towards the sky, then the sadness takes us to the, like the roots, it makes us more stronger, like the root makes the tree more stronger by going down into the womb of the earth. Both are needed in our life. And the higher a tree goes, the deeper it goes simultaneously. That means if tree will become higher and higher, the height of the tree will increase, then root also has to go more deeper inside the earth to make it strong. Like that, happiness and sadness is also making us more perfect, more patient and to understand the life better. The bigger the tree, the bigger will be its roots. If we have more happiness, then sadness is also important for making us more perfect. In fact, it is the ways in proportion. It is always in proportion, thanks it balance. So its balance should be there, said by Osho. That means equally happiness and sadness are both important for our life to make us more perfect. More quotes are there about this. One does not have to go away to make room for the other. Joy and sorrow can coexist even in grieving heart. If we are very sad, then also we should think about the joys in our life that we have. Now some questions are given in the same page 33 about this joy and sorrow. So let us see about these questions also. First question is, do sufferings come to us by chance? Answer is no. Sufferings do not come to us by chance. Any suffering is not coming by chance. Now second question, who sends us suffering? Answer is God sends us suffering. No suffering is come by chance. It comes by the divine mercy. That means by the God for our own perfections. So it is sent by the God. Why do we have exams in school? So answer is, we have exams in our school to check our progress and increase our perfection in our study. If there would be no exam, then the student will not understand about their perfection, about their patience, about their progress. So it is very important to have exams in our school. Question 4 is, would a student progress more if there were no exams? No. A student would not progress more if there were no exams, because they would not be able to understand that how much progress they have done or how much perfect they are, that they should know, and they can be more perfect, they can increase their perfection more and more by this test. Question number 5, why do you think God sends us suffering? In the same sense, God also sends us suffering for our own perfection and progress. God is also time to time takes our test by giving us sufferings, grief and sorrow, because God also wants to make us more perfect, and God also wants that we should progress more and more. That's why God sends us suffering, so that we can be more perfect and more patient, and we can understand the life better when we have some sorrows with our joys. So both are equally important in our life, to understand it and to feel the life. So thank you, students. We will meet in the next class again. Thank you, all of you.